Hello, I'm a sovereign and lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist preaching Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia free. And I have made just a t-shirt design on this thing. And this is the front of the, this is the front of the t-shirt on Sufi Muslims. So you will get it on my website also. I will give you the link. And this is the back. And so Christianity is the same thing as Islam. It is both of heart and not of the dead letters. So Jesus has come to set us free of the bounds of the law. Letters are law, which we call Sharia in Arabic. So Christianity is ritual and Sharia free. And this priest, don't call a priest, which are super blind, they have taken over the seat of the rabbi that Jesus got rid of by giving his own sacrifice, in which the curtain of the holiest of holy, which is of Elohim, Allah, PARBRAHM temple, were torn from top to bottom. That means no high priest or the village priest is required in Christ Jesus. A real or the ideal priest, they were created by Jesus in the 70 outer circle laborers. So they had the top root, his word, and they preach, they teach the scripture without any alteration or impurity. So this is the ideal rabbi which Jesus defined, and he came to fulfill the law, not to destroy it. So, here it is. There is the top root, which is the of scripture. So this is scripture. Without this top root, the tree is dead. That's why Jesus said, let the dead bury their dead. This top root is the oral Torah, or his word, that Jesus came to deliver to the rabbi. But they love darkness. They wanted to pry the dead letters. As in the chapter on circumcision, you will see that they were circumcising Gentiles and slaves for the sake of money. Whereas the circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Only the seed of Isaac can be circumcised, nobody else. If somebody else gets circumcised, he changes his tribal father and he becomes super bastard fanatic devil. But they try to introduce this circumcision into the Church of God, but there was a resistance. They could not do it. But when they entered the fold of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, first Hazrat Muhammad says, wherever you find a Jew, kill him. Then humbly they introduced themselves into the Islam of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib. And there they bring in the, all the temple practices, which is including the blood sacrifice or kosher, which is halal, and prayer and fasting, and also the circumcision. Circumcision were done on openly. remember that our brother, Angel Stephen, the first martyr, he was baptizing Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, as John the Baptist was doing. But the temple priest was not happy. They wanted to make Jew outwardly here. And he made them Jew inwardly, spiritual, outwardly tribal people to establish a covenant with Abraham. So the temple priest called them, and in the Sanhedrin, he gave a long speech. Here it is, you know. Here is the Adam. Under Adam you have this races. Under races you have tribes. So here you are. There's no Jew here, or Hindu, Sikh, or Muslim. So this tribal, the planet Earth is for the habitation of the tribal people, not for the Hindu, Sikh, or Muslim, or Jew, or other people. Now, in Russia, there's more tribal instinct than in Europe or in America. So Russia is going to win the atomic war because they have the right to live on this planet Earth. The other people don't have a right, and that's why they are super bastards. What Tony Blair and Bush did to Iraq on the blasphemy that Saddam Hussein has weapon of mass destruction, but none were found there by a major general who is running a ministry. And I told him to go to the rooftop to proclaim that there were no weapons of mass destruction. Tony Blair and Bush, they are blasphemer, hypocrites of the first degree. But he won't do it. They say the British attitude. British is a nation of shopkeepers. They cannot deliver gospel. Gospel is delivered by people like French farming people, more farming community. French and other people who do farming. Among the farmers you find guts to speak the gospel truth, not among the shopkeepers, British shopkeepers. So a Jew is inwardly spiritual, like Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian. Not a single Jew was born or died, but the tribal people led by their blind rabbi without the knowledge of the Oral Torah. The Samaritans possessed the knowledge of the Oral Torah because they were faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh. They did not need baptism. James and John went to a Samaritan village to baptize them. They said, we don't need baptism. Go to another village. So they came back to Jesus, put that village on fire as Elijah did. Jesus said, you don't know what spirit you are of. The one from the inner circle, he came to do the will of our supernatural Father, not his own will. People from the outer circle, they did their own will. They had the knowledge of the Oral Torah, like the Samaritans. So Samaritan was a nation of prophets. And those 70 outer circle neighbors, they were trained as prophets, Elijah, in the name of John the Baptist. So here, I want to tell you that in Jesus, you are set free. And that is how you do that free. You enter the fold of God, in the company of God. John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, making them the son of the tribal people. And they established their covenant with Abraham, who was ideal Adam, Sarah was Eve, and they were given the promised land as Garden of Eden. Through them we learn all the moral laws that we need. So So that's why Jesus said, do what the rabbi tells you to do, but do not follow their example. They were crook. So here it is. He baptized them in the name of the Abraham, making them tribal people. That tribal seed is to be sown, to turn into plant, which is twice born. So no tribal, no seed, no son of the tribal father illa. You cannot be son of the supernatural father Allah. Allah, Elohim, PARBRAHM are the same thing. And Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, same thing. So this is the creation of Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, and John the Baptist worked for Yahweh. His God was Yahweh, and Christ Jesus worked for Elohim, Allah, PARBRAHM. So this seed of our tribal father is to be buried and turned into plant, and that plant then knock at the door, and the door is opened and you come to it. Here we have one father, supernatural father, Allah, PARBRAHM, Elohim, and we are all sons of the Father. Son represents father, not the daughter. So here we are fishers of men. No woman is here. That's why St. Thomas said, unless a female, here they are female, disciple of the rabbi, unless a female becomes a male, solitary person, becomes a male, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. So Peter was sitting here, because he was once born, not twice born. He was the gatekeeper. I made a t-shirt design on that one too, which I'm putting it on. And you can see them on my website. So here I want to stress that Jesus came to the sons of the Most High, Elohim, Allah, PARBRAHM. They are not bound by letter. Their Bible is not allowed there. Our covenant is of Holy Spirit and not of the dead letters. That's why Luke 16, verse 16, it stated that law and prophets were till John the Baptist. And after that, Christ Jesus opened the narrow gate to the royal kingdom of God, where there is no Bible allowed, which is the Jewish leaven. Jewish leaven, which Jesus forbade. So these people who are thumping Bible in the churches, they are Christian, dead in letters, super dead in letters. Ask them, you know, the university professors in whose name John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water, and why he did not baptize a woman, a Gentile, or a Samaritan. They can't answer it. If one that answer it, let me know. Ask them, you know, don't be shy. Ask your priest so that he should also know his limitation. He's working for money. He's a hireling. And when the wolf comes, he runs away. That's why the gospel was broken or given to the shepherd in the field who were tending their sheep, and they were ready to die for their sheep, and not to the university professors in Jerusalem, the hireling, who will run away when the wolf comes. So much more you can learn from my videos, but here I want to say that when you enter the fold of God, you become the son of God, then you are not bound by law or anything. You are a free man. And I think there is a word used by the people, the freed people, freed men, they were called them. And this is demonstrated by Paul and Silas, they opposed the statues, and he said, this is the time of worship in spirit and not these statues anymore. In Christ Jesus, John 4, Samaritan woman at the well. The five husbands of the Samaritan woman, they were spiritual and not physical. And I have put their names in the Trinity, which is you find under the description at the bottom, the names of the five husbands. So, in Jesus then told Samaritan woman, who became St.Photina, and all whole village became apostle, because they were all prophets. Samaritans were all prophets. That you worship God not on this mountain or that mountain in Jerusalem, but in spirit, in truth and in spirit. Whatever you see, as Peter was doing, whatever he saw, he told Jesus without twisting it. No duplicity. And that is the truth. If you know that truth, then you have the love for the absolute truth. But if you can't have this truth, which you can see, then you don't love the gospel truth, which is the absolute truth. So many people are liars, and liars do not get gospel truth. So you worship in truth and in spirit means not in by the dead letters of the book, you know, Bible or anything, but what is written here and there. What comes out of your heart where God is resting. This is the temple of God. God lives in the temple. I am taught by God. He is in here. And that kitab, that book is called Al-Kitab. Kitab means book. Al means the book of God. So prophets have that book. With this book, the tree of the law becomes green, as the Samaritan woman were. Or the Samaritan people who picked up the wounded person. Dead in letters, Rabbi and Pharisee Sadducee passed by, leaving him to die. Hypocrisy. They tell you love God, but they hate people. Same in Church of England, headed by Queen, now is headed by King. On the 11th of this month, they remember that the soldiers who died in World War I and World War II, they glorified God. Now you can see how intelligent these white people are. How can you glorify God by killing and looting people? Whereas Salvation Army people say, which are much hated by the Church of England people, that they died, their soldiers died for king and country, which is the gospel truth. But they hate them. They serve people. They are not racist. Whereas Church of England is a racist. Only the Church of England bishop can sit in the House of Lords. Nobody else. Racist, you know. So they are sons of Satan. Nothing to do with God. And that's why the England has become a land of the crooks. I have been cheated by these ombudsmen and other people. There is no justice. Ombudsmen are working like mafia. And these crook businesses are enjoying it. Anybody prepared to help me? I will give him all these cases to deal for me. So what I want to stress here, that once your law binds you, and that finished up to John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. In Christ Jesus, we are in Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit sets you free. because you go by what is in your heart and what not what is written in the book, as the Samaritan man did, and so did the shepherd in the field. They went for their heart and not looking at the book, you know, what they should do before they act. So they possess the Holy Spirit. So gospel is for the people who are illiterate, farm workers, honest to God, and not feed the people in the churches, dog collar priests, who paid money to learn the dead letters. And to recoup their money, they work as priests in the churches, as hireling shepherds. When the wolf comes, they run away. Or where they get a better job, more money, they leave the church and go their shift. So they are opportunists, you know. So they are mammon opportunists. So you get nothing from them. And though churches here, they are producing super blind disciples. Indeed, we don't have disciples. We have laborers only, working in the vineyard of our supernatural Father, which is above this secular world, celestial world of Southern mentality. Now, when you reach that stage, and you are, the gospel comes from your heart, and not from the book anymore, then you are son of the Most High, Elohim, Allah, PARBRAHM. And that's why Jesus came to make us. And there was a saint in Gennesaret who was preaching gospel, but he was like Jehovah Witness people. He was going to the roadside and telling people, look, this is the gospel truth. And people were not interested to listen to him. They reported it to their rabbi. A rabbi, as you know, what Jesus preached is opposite to the rabbi. In rabbis, tit for tat, Moses' law. In Christ Jesus, Holy Spirit. If somebody hit you on one cheek, present the other. You hit at the conscience of the person, not at the body of the person. At his soul, at his mind, you hit him. As Saul was hit on his mind when he was torturing the laborers of Jesus. In his heart, he was not happy because he was the disciple of Gamaliel. He had to obey him as a good disciple. So he was torturing them and all that thing he was doing. So for his heart, Christ Jesus intervened and opened his heart to take him out the clutches of the Gamaliel and set him free in Holy Spirit with capital S. Same as the one given the reward to the 12, you know, the last one was picked up at the last 12, the Holy Spirit with capital S. Much more you can learn from my other videos. So let's carry on with this, who was set free. So the person at the Gennesaret who was preaching gospel to the people at the roadside, as the Jehovah Witnesses do, they reported him to the rabbi. And a local rabbi tell them, lock him in the silence of the graveyard so nobody should listen to him. As to me, the same thing, you know, I go to the Oxford University, I put on this hoodie in one seminar of Christian and Jews. They told me, oh, you can't put on this hoodie. I told them it's a light on the living lampstand. No, students don't like it. Their dog collar priest then told me to not to come attend. He threw me out of the conference. So same, you will be also thrown out from the churches and synagogues and other places if you are set free by Christ Jesus. So this man was locked in the silence of the graveyard. Because Jesus had set him free, they were put heavy chain around him. All chain broke off. Remember, Peter was locked in jail with the heavy chain bound him, and angel set him free. Same way the angel set him, this man in the graveyard free. And when Christ Jesus came, he taught them a good lesson by drowning 2,000 swine into this lake and teaching them a good lesson for maltreating the saint. And what the Bible says in the written, that he had demons in his head. Bloody hell. Such is the darkness you have got it. No demons in his head. He was a saint. How a person with a demon in his head could be set free when he was bound by chain? No way. But a man of God, chain, our Father set him free. Same way, Paul and Silas, they were opposing the statue makers and other people who were making that. This is not the time of these statues anymore. It is the time of worship of living God and not these dead piece of wood turned into a statue and people worship it. Like stone turned into a figure and people worship it. This is stone worship for the spiritually blind people. So this is the time of the living God, which lives in your temple. This is the temple of God. God lives in here. Me and my Father are one. My Father teaches me what I have to say. I only say what pleases my Father and not pleases the public, which the psychic will do, politician will do. Politician are number one. Blasphemer, Tony Blair and Bush, that Sadamus had a weapon of mass destruction, they were none at all. So they were number one blasphemer on the war criminals. So Putin is going to sort them up, America and the West, who bombed Iraq, Libya and Syria. Righteous people. You know what they did. Don't keep your mouth shut. Open your mouth and proclaim it on from the rooftop that they were blasphemers and you are going to reap the fruit of blasphemy, which you will see is not sweet. Putin is super Hitler. Hitler killed the sinners, those people who broke their covenant with Abraham, Jew outwardly. And super Hitler is going to kill the blasphemers who are unfaithful to our Father, supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, PARBRAHM. So very interesting things are happening now. So Paul and Silas, when they opposed those statues, they presented them to the council because they paid the money to them, you know. So they were influential with the council, and the council mayor and other people told them, stone them to death, and they stoned them. And they were so much wounded that they were taken, left for dead. But God was with them. So they woke up and then they were put in the jail. They were not set free, put in the jail after being stoned. At night, all start singing, Paul and Silas start singing the praises of our supernatural Father. The prisoners who were not Mammon lovers, they looted the rich people and gave it to the poor, like Robin Hood type of people. When they listened that gospel, they understood it. And when they understood it, then their chain fell off, all their things fell off, and they were set free. In the morning, the jailer came, found the vault broken, no chains, prisoner all free. He was frightened to kill himself. Paul said, no, no, don't kill, we are all here. So that is the love called agape. And all one brethren God agape. And whereas in the Mammon infested town, they were hated by the Mammon worshipper as these soldiers who killed people in the World War I and World War II. The Church of England glorified that, they glorified God. So what type of God was that? It was the God, same one as those who stoned Paul and Silas to death. So this is the time when you have to open your mouth and say what is in here and what not what is written in the book, because that is gone with John the Baptist. So these Bible thumpers, you see them carrying Bible under their armpit. They are all blasphemer hypocrites. They don't understand them. They are called them super donkeys carrying holy books. So these university professors who teach them and who argue over what is written here and there, and they are authority on the New Testament and Old Testament, they are super donkey carrying holy books. They have no knowledge of the gospel. There are many corruptions and they can't sort it out. Jesus had no disciple. The root of the word disciple is disciple. Rabbi, Pharisees, Lucy, they had disciples. In Jesus, we are twice more laborers, workers, and not disciples. So you can see they don't know. And they call Jesus Lord, Lord has slaves. And then, today I went to the church. Over there they were singing. And they are saying that he is the King of the Kings. King of the Kings. Mean emperor. Christ, Jesus was emperor. Then I told one of the men, the kings, they charge taxes. They charge taxes money. So how much the King of the Kings will charge? Lot of emperor, he will charge a lot. They don't know that Jesus was a royal king. Royal king means freely received, freely given. We are royal priests in God. Freely we receive from our supernatural Father inside here, and freely we give. So these people who say prayer that Father in heaven, he is not in heaven. They are spiritually blind disciples of these rabbis, Pharisees, Surti, which are dog collar priest, bishop and pope. They are all Antichrist. So they are the disciples of the Antichrist, and that is how they are reflected, that they don't know that God lives in his temple and not in heaven anymore. And St. Paul has said so very clearly that God is no more alienated. He is living in your own heart. That demiurge called Yahweh is alienated. Real God lives in living temple. much more you can learn from my other videos, but it is getting quite a big video now. Our Father God bless you in agape, which is the love of the brethren, of the twice born brethren in God, divine love, unconditional divine love.